Hi, I'm Sterling Edwards. Let's spend about 5 minutes glazing color. Now, what do we mean by glazing color? Glazing color is where you take an existing shape or object in a painting and you put a very thin layer of color on top of it, preferably a transparent layer. It's like stacking stained glass. If I have a blue piece of stained glass and I lay a yellow piece on top of it and hold it to the light, I see green. So you got one color on top of another color, which creates a third color. Glazing is very popular in watercolors, particularly, especially in transparent watercolor, because you can put four or five glazes of color on top of each other, letting them dry in between glazes, and get the most incredible stacked shapes of colors, which are quite luminous and very attractive. I've got a tree here. It's just a very simple tree, which I painted using a brown, and it's dry. Now, I'm gonna take another color like violet and glaze on top of that and suggest maybe a few cast shadows or a little bit of texture. The key to glazing, of course, like I said, is make sure that the existing shape is dry before you do it. If you put a wet brush on a wet shape, now you're not glazing, you're charging. So this is all about glazing. Glazing means putting a color on top of the dry shape. So let's take some wet violet and do a quick little glaze on top of this tree. And now I want you to watch the difference it makes. We've got the violet right here. And of course I've got the brown, which is this. Now watch the difference it makes when you put the violet on top of the brown, we'll get a third color, which is this. It's a very, very, very attractive grayish brown. It's almost like mixing the color on the palette, except you're doing it on the paper, on dry paper. And by this way, you can really control the shape. So if we want to put a few cast shadows across this little tree, and paint a shadow side on the tree, we can do this. It's a combination of these two colors. We create a third color, which is a very violet gray. Glazing is a beautiful technique. A lot of times I do this when I'm painting landscapes or painting florals. It's a good way to add a lot of dimension and a lot of depth to a painting. So that little shape that before was just a very flat, two-dimensional shape of a tree, it now takes a little bit of a three-dimensional look. It has more depth and more volume to it. Also more color variety and more interest. Glazing is a wonderful technique. Now I've also done a little demonstration on how to charge color. Now here's another tree. If you have a chance, watch the demo, the little tip on charging color. Look at the difference between these two trees. This one was actually done on dry paper by glazing color on top of it. This was a demonstration I did on charging color. Charging color is where you take an existing wet shape, while it's still wet, you start dropping other colors into it and let the paint kind of mix on its own. Don't brush them together. If I took the violet and the brown and brushed them together, I'd have just one solid color. I want that color variety. That gives a piece more interest and more texture. So we got two different ways to enhance a painting. By glazing color, which is putting a thin layer of wash on top of dry color or dry shape. And then we have charging color, which is taking advantage of that wet paper and that wet paint and dropping a few more colors into it while it's still wet. These are both great ways to enhance a painting, give your shapes much more interest, and make the piece more desirable and have more dimension as well. Just a quick tip to help you out. Thank you.